All right, so excellent. So we have the DAO here manipulating this data. Let's implement just a couple more things here. Let's do a find student by ID. All right, so this might take as argument a student ID and return students.find the student that whose ID matches the student ID, right? And let's make sure that that student is a string. So let's parse integer. Let's parse it. Make sure that even if it's a string, we'll parse it. And on the server, we can implement it as follows. We can say we can map it against a following get. So get, you know, API students and then slash student ID, and the function might be find student by ID, which implements here as find student by ID. And this takes as argument request and response. And this is going to return the JSON that comes back from the student DAO, find student by ID. Looks like we didn't expose it in the API. Let's go back, make sure that this is also part of the API. Now it's accessible. And we're going to pass in this parsed from the parameters. All right, so this is going to parse in the request that params and mapped the map keyed by student ID. So that's what we're passing. This is going to come back presumably with that one student, and that's what we're going to return in JSON. Let's try it again. Let's run this. So these are all the students, but if I ask only for Alice, I only get Alice, right? Or if I only ask for Ada, I only get Ada. Everybody good? All right, awesome.